stimulative presentation. I have hope now we'll have intensive and fruitful discussion or debate. According to our rules, because especially we have more person than normally, I will give voice to everyone which won't take the voice, but please limit the time of your speech, not as the co-referat, co-discussion, just question, suggestion, or critics, or comments. You're welcome. Who wants to take the voice first?
Well, thank you very much. I was really impressed and touched by your presentation, which is not very easy to be discussed in this manner. But just maybe one thing that I have that really touches me, it is a suggestion, not a critic. Please don't take it negatively. In the second part of your presentation, whenever you said no, you put very clear polarization between it is that, but our African tradition is like that. While in the first part, for example, you said there is the breast ironing, or there is a woman has no right to inheritance. You never said even not even once that this is the effect of our African tradition, which actually it is. So that polarization in the second part, maybe it was maybe too, according to me of course, it was maybe too pejorative, showing you see it is we and them. While in the first part it was like not clear from where those bad treating of women came. Surely not from the Western world. But we know it is rooted in the local culture, traditional religion. So in order to keep balance, it should be also said in the first part. But just a suggestion, I really appreciate your presentation.
Definitely, I appreciate that comment, suggestion. And what you say is the fact, because while I was writing the first section of the second part, I didn't try to say maybe we Africans, our culture, this is what actually our culture have brought about. But definitely, I presuppose the knowledge that we know that this is our culture. And when I was discussing about the first part, I was saying what the Western feministic movement can bring to Africa. It can better this our cultures. So the first part, which I try to say, the advantages the Western feminist movement can bring to Africa. I didn't see any need to now maybe repeat that this is a product of our own African culture. So I presuppose that we have this culture, but with this Western movement of feminism, we can better this culture. And if you see now in the second part, I also see the positive side of our culture. Now saying also, look at the negative impact this Western movement, feminism, can bring to our culture. And then try to see a way to balance the two. So, actually I thank you for your comments, suggestion, as understand.
Maybe you can introduce yourself because I don't know your name.
So my name is Masaru Masanja. I'm a student from Zimbabwe University. I'm doing law. I just want to make a few comments. Maybe why we need feminism, because women were not allowed to inherit or to have property in Africa. I think we need to go deeper on why some of the African culture they never really prohibit a woman to inherit, but have to take it in a wider context. Basically, like if you take a customs, maybe higher customs, women are not allowed to inherit, but they had a right to use the land of the community until when they get out of home, and when they return, they are also allowed to use that land of the community. they are not totally prohibited, but from the cultural context, because when women are married to a man, it means that they belong to that family. So you cannot take a land of the community. Maybe if she's married to whom, that land cannot belong to another community. That's also the reason. I think we should also appreciate that thing. Another thing, maybe also to comment also on why we don't need the. We said no, we don't need the feminism because of homosexuality and sex marriage, something like that. I think there was a study, it was done by the Makerere lecturer called Sylvia Matar, Sylvia Temari. She argued clearly, in fact, not only that lecture, but even from an anthropological point of view, it is not that in Africa there are no this kind of homosexual practices or whatever. That's not in any. It was there, and it is there in African culture. So it is refuted by the anthropological studies that even in African cultures there are some tendencies of this homosexuality. Even at a biological point of view, they say even some animals. So it's not the issue of culture. Probably, even maybe it's concerned also biological and so on. So I think that argument saying that we Africans we don't have this, I think from an anthropological point of view, it's incorrect. And also the same issue for abortion, I think for me I take a different stand on that. I think feminism will help that, because if you look on the number in Tanzania, you may take it at a religious point of view, but if you look, many girls in Tanzania are subjected to procure abortion to the medical officers who are not well equipped in terms of medical knowledge. And they end up there to lose a lot of lives to these young girls. So you can take it as a chance, because even if you still you prohibit, but underground people are doing it. So there's no any point of people are doing it underground, and you risk lives of these most of young men and young women into that horrible situation. Because you know, when someone makes a decision to go to do abortion, it's not an easy decision. It takes time. It is so painful. And also, the same issue of moral decadence. But generally, I think our feminism, I think it brings a new discussion in the African context. We can discuss, but I want to be cautioned that we should not take the debate of feminism in Europe or in America, and we plant them in Africa. I think they won't work. I think we should contextualize it in African context. I think that one would be appropriate and more successful to the Africans. But if we plant, we take the ideas hostile, because the feminism in Europe, I think, based on the presumption if men and the women, they are hostile and so forth. But in Africa, it is quite different. So I think we should put it into context of Africa. I think to be more specific.
Thank you for your erudite comment, indeed, because it was really helpful in maybe clarifying some things I didn't clarify. Like, first issue about land. We know that when we talk about land in Africa, that there is a lot of things involved. In fact, the land conflict in Africa is one of the biggest conflicts we have contemporary living in Africa. Even in the contemporary Africa, this is one of the biggest conflicts. So maybe I'm not going to argue from the perspective that women are allowed, men now, to use the land before getting married. But what about those women that after getting married, now they come back, they are divorced, or maybe their husband died, and they are sent back home. Now they come back and realize that the land where they were farming, another person has taken it. What about them? And you forget also that even in this context of you are free to use the land, before you go out, that this is also a matter of now the fight for the fetal position, which is one of the biggest conflicts in land issues in Africa, the fetal position. When the woman comes back, she's realized, this is my position, I was farming on this area. And now this another person has taken this area. It becomes a conflict. Why? Because they are not allowed to inherit the land. And maybe we can further discussion on this issue, maybe it's further research. And concerning the idea of abortion, I have a case. You say, because in Africa, people are having a visa, people are doing this implicitly. So even if we don't analyze it, people are doing it on their time. But remember, in Africa, people are stealing. People are stealing implicitly. So also, we can also legalize stealing, since people are stealing. Since people now are killing implicitly, then we can legalize killing. And you realize that such logic cannot be applied in every aspect of life in Africa. So we can't say, because some people are doing this, then let's do this, let's legalize this. It's not logically true. And therefore, we can say that even though some people are doing it, it is not allowed by law. So, and there are reasons why the law does not allow it, and it is very clear. Concerning the statement to say that even in Africa, lesbianism and homosexuality were existing. Yes, they were existing, but they were not existing as a form of marriage, legally allowed in Africa. Even though they were existing, they were not there as a form of marriage that now I can legally marry this person. Maybe I can legally now, maybe this is an Africa, I can legally marry this person. It's, definitely it wasn't there. The form of homosexuality that was existing is the ritual cleansings, like I think you, if you check many traditions, I saw some of the ritual cleansing where an elder, when an elder ejaculates, young boys who are now being initiated, initiation rites are asked now to go there and take the host off. These are issues that are actually homosexuality. But in Africa, like, clearly a man to marry another man is alien, and it's a fact. Thank you.
I don't have a question or comment. I just wanted to be sure whether you meant what you said, and if no, then we correctify. You said in your presentation that it is lawful that men can rape women, but the opposite is not true. I presuppose you meant that the law in Tanzania criminalizes rape by men, but it does not criminalize rape by women. I think if that's what you meant, then I have no case.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was trying to say. That in Tanzania, Tanzanian constitution, women cannot rape men, but men can rape women. So even if the woman, like in several countries, even the other day in the United States, several girls ganged up and raped a man. So in Tanzania, even if women do that, actually, the opposite is the truth. You see? Yeah. Even if women do that, the opposite is true. I discussed that when I was talking about irrational feminism. Because now we are doing this, saying that it is feminism, because women should be preserved. Women are better. Something like women are also weak. That's what we are trying to say.
No, my point is, the way you put your phrase, it gives an implication that the law, Tanzanian law, allows rape by men. Yeah. While what you meant is that the law criminalizes only rape by men, but does not recognize.
Criminalize.
Yeah,
that's true. Actually, Tanzanian law, it criminalizes men raping women, but actually there is no place in the law where there is an issue of women raping men, which also is a reality in most African countries, even here possibly. But But it's not a criminal issue.
My name is Jamila Musa. I'm in Form 5. Thank you for your presentation. On my side, according to me, in Tanzania, African students need some aspects of female, because hence we are being married. After they are, after men divorcing us, we are remaining without any properties. For example, there are some cultures, there are some traditions in Tanzania. After being married, if you had, you have been enhanced something, some properties, for example, land. After being divorced, you remain and properties. Thus, you will not have any problem.
Thank you for that suggestion, which I tried to stipulate on it earlier, concerning maybe divorced women, people who were sent back, maybe the husband died, what they can use for survival. Thank you for that.